I want to tell you something similar you heard for satellite instruments. We have some software to organize aircraft missions. And it's a software which was developed by an other company. And so at the moment, as this becomes open source, I would be able to work on this. So it was important to get it open source first. I'm a programmer at the Forschungszentrum Jülich. This is a center in Germany, nearby Cologne, which has a big supercomputer. And I work in an institute for energy and climate in a sub-department for stratospheric chemistry. I'm since many years in the Python Software Foundation and also in the Python Software Verband. That's a German equivalent. If you want to mention me, you can use my name on Twitter. And this is some of the area where we work. So now to explain a little bit so that you are not lost in all this, what I want to tell. If you have made your last trip by aircraft to vacation somewhere, you have maybe have similar view. So you see clouds. And this is the atmosphere where we live. Usually we find us on the very ground, but it's not very known why the structure of the clouds looks like this. And so there will be a lot of investigation. And maybe from school, you remember how the little bit about how the atmosphere looks like we are living in. We are living in this part, it's named the troposphere. In the past, you know, all the roofs, they were not so high as now, because then people recognized the smell about this, and they did not like it, so the roofs get higher altitude. And what we all have here in this area is biomass burning and the urban pollution. You know, this, there are some pictures from China where they have a very thick smog all time. And a little bit higher, we have cirrus clouds. And also thunderstorms, there are some chemical reactions possible because of the energy there. If there's lightning, you have chemical reactions. And all this is in a movement. The atmosphere has movements from the equator to the poles. And there are some other mechanisms. And some of this stuff gets in the area where we do our work. We are in this stratosphere focus and on some transport mechanism, all stuff from there goes there. And in the past, you know, there was the problem with the ozone hole. So that's important that we have ozone in the stratosphere, otherwise we have much more sunburn problems. So we do atmospheric research because we want to help to have more data so that we can make prediction about the climate, the global warming, and maybe something similar like the ozone hole we have already solved by political reactions on it, that we forbid some substances in air. So, and to get all this knowledge, you can do a lot in laboratory. You can find out some substance like this reacts in this time with some other substance, and this gives then these products. You can do this by instruments measuring this also on balloons, on aircrafts, and what we heard in the last talk, this is done already also by satellites, and there's a new project to make this very small sats, which are not so expensive and can be much more than in the past. And also, with all this knowledge, you can make your models. So you can simulate the atmosphere. You try to simulate on the supercomputers all your knowledge about the movements of particles and their reactions. For us, it's important to understand all these individual processes. So if you have an air parcel, a cloud or something, it's a big air parcel, you can imagine about this is moving. There's, of course, water in it, but there are also chemical reactions happening. And this is, we try to understand this and to parameterize this and put this also in different models, which are not, it's a worldwide project with to get data in models and find out more about this. And at the end, it's an ongoing process of quality improvements. Programming the same. Should you do always have tests and improve your data, improve your code. So the thing is that aircraft mission is less complicated than a satellite mission because it's just you can hire an aircraft. It's not so expensive, and you can send the aircraft to a region where you want. And so, but it's also a thing that it's not so cheap that you can buy an aircraft mission on your own. You have to make this in collaboration. And you have a lot of groups on such an aircraft then. And then you may have 10 days, several flight hours together. But you may have also different interests. So this is an aircraft we could use. It was in the past a spy aircraft from the Russian military. It has a range from 3,000 kilometers and an altitude by 20 kilometers. So and we start this, for example, from Kiruna or from India, or we try to start it from Nepal and fly in some regions where no one has data yet. So that shows an image how different people try to add their stuff to the aircraft. There are several bays, so you can have a lot, also a wing pod for special instruments. There's, for example, an instrument which is always on the right side of the aircraft and can only measure if you do the right turn. So it looks in a different direction then. So and it should not look into the sun. And so there are some circumstances you have to care for. And this is a long list of instruments for different substances by a lot of groups, different institutes in Europe who have then their instruments. And then the problem is we have not the same goal. They have money got for different kind of measurements. But we are all on the same aircraft. So another one is the HALO aircraft. This is a German aircraft. It has an altitude by 15 kilometers, but a much larger range, about 10,000 kilometers. So now we have those people who are able to finance together such an aircraft. But so that has then to start from some airbase. We can plan by model simulations to find out where they may have their interests and get this fit together. So we try to find out for all these groups the optimized flight path. And there are also not only our wishes, there are also the problems that some territory is protected. You like to fly over this, but it's forbidden. So you have to take a lot of constraints in this. And we solved this by a software. And this is the mission support software. A various groups started in 2010 something to develop a software which can solve this issue that many groups together can plan in the region where the aircraft should go. And Mark Rautenhaus from the DLR, he had the best idea by this. And he based his software on the OGC web maps service. We heard this in the talk before. And in May 2016, this project becomes open source. This made it At this moment, possible for several groups to join in and to use and extend the software. One of the first things we did was that we put it on Anaconda. It's a ConvaForge application. Its license is Apache 2, and we also use read the docs. And Mark did before already a GMT publication about it, so that it is also known in science. And the basic principle by this is, we heard this, I will repeat a little from this, is that we have a server which has data and a client which can request by a getMap request what data is there. The extension we have is that we not only get the data, we also get the plot. So we request something for a layer, time, elevation, some projection type, and the client then visualizes the plot. This means we have petabyte of data somewhere, and only at the location where we plan the aircraft mission, where the scientists with the pilots are together, they can exchange data in this way that they look at the same images. What the software at the moment is that we have a server application, which is all pure Python, which is able to manage the data located on the server. We have this already for the ETM-WF, the chemical clumps model, also some others, Meteosat data, for example. And at the moment, it is a Qt4 client interface. So we are going to Qt5 at the moment. And this client interacts then with the server. And on the server can implement the plotting routines or also the data access routines. So you can have different kind of products added. And the scientists then draws just in this data, and this gives a flight path, and this then can be exchanged and discussed, and the waypoints, if the scientists are happy with this, they have to show it to the pilot, and the pilot says, no, I can't go there, or we have to fly a higher level there, or something else, and then they can discuss this again, and then at the end, they have the flight path. This architecture is that we have a Whiskey application, which is based on Pasty on the server side. And our data format is a common data format, NetCDF. This is in atmospheric science, the most used, or one of the most used formats. And also you have to design your data driver for this, your product of data, and also the visualization definitions. And the GUI application, it has some views. At the moment, we have a top view. This means you can look at a horizontal view of the data, or on side view means you have a vertical view on your data at the point where your flight path is. So you draw your flight path, and it calculates how the data will look like at this view. All the table view, this is that you have a table where your coordinates are, and then you can have a loop view which a lot of images could display on your screen. And there are some other parts added. Flight performance, for example, means you have data about the aircraft, about the weight, about the fuel, so that you know you can't go further, because there's not enough fuel on board, or you can reach the highest altitude because now the aircraft has not so much weight anymore. The software is, because it's on Conda Forge, we have to add a Conda channel. This describes the installation process and also how to run this product. And it is using an environment that can also be done without. So it's just the command conda install MSS, and you have everything. We have demo data implemented, so that's easier to set up your own server or just try something. And so we have, this is the part then to start the server, and this is GUI. And you see here how it looks like, and on the right side how the loader looks. If you look at the top view then, it's all in Qt. And so you have a map. At this point, someone decided this flight path. This is just by clicking on the symbols and adding this route. So you can also zoom into this, and then you get new images from the data server. If you look at the side view, this is how the aircraft should fly in altitude. You see this also in a table, the table view in coordinates, and all the time. You could also request new data for different species. This is on this pull-down menu, or on a different height level. Height is based on pressure, because aircrafts like to fly on pressure level. That's a thing you have to know. And so that's simulated data here, and you can look, okay, if I put my flight path here, I would be in this region, and maybe this is for showing the cloud index. I come here into a cloud, and by discussing this with all scientists together, you can just optimize where to fly. And so they get all their wishes usually fulfilled, so that they say, okay, we do this flight this day, and it is paid, and then the problem is solved. And everyone then has the data he wants to have. So we can also add other stuff on top view. For example, satellite tracks. Sometimes the aircraft measurements are used to check some of the instruments on the satellite, or to find out if the data is comparable. Then also there are some remote sensing stuff, or you'd like to have a KML overlay. So if you like, for example, have some borders known or territoria where you are not able to overfly, you can just add it by a KML overlay. Also you can have very complex flight patterns added. One is, for example, is a hexagon flight pattern. This is because there's some instrument possible on board which likes to make some kind of round pattern from the same air. These are some examples how it's already used. This was a flight from Kiruna to Oberpfaffenhofen. All these namings here, that's the work from the pilot, because there are some aircraft control systems which have names. And if we take some route on, you know this, there's not much difference if you go to Mallorca or something else. You have always a quite similar route, and you don't fly another route. This is because that's the path to go to some place by aircraft is fixed. So, and the pilot knows all this information. If you want to do a measurement research flight, you like to fly maybe different, but at some point it's not possible because the pilot has to pass some of the signals. So then he writes in this flight track all this kind of positions he has to pass, and then it could be rechecked if still the goal of research is possible, and if so, then the flight path is done. This is an N2O, that's Lachgas in German. it's yeah, I don't know. It's in the medicine used to often used, and it's an important gas. Also, the ozone on this side, it's just shows what kind of levels of this species then would be found if we measure there. Also on side views, you see, then the aircraft goes up, and then flies around here's latitude, longitude on this axis, and climbs again, because it could do this at this point, because the weight, it has already used a lot of fuel, and it's now less weight, and so it can climb higher. And then it puts the last part, and then it's worth landing somewhere. And then it starts again for the next flight. There are two flights in this picture. Here you see also some other thing. You have not only the people who are organizing the flights have their instruments there. There are a lot of data centers involved. And at the moment you have some idea where you need maybe data or want data, you also ask all these data centers to prepare data sets for this. But at some kind, sometimes there are reasons you have to fly to some other place. And this is here the white area, for example. There was then in some other data sets, there was something very interesting there, but not all of the extend their range automatically, because you want to have maybe data just from 60 degree to something, and some are able to prepare more data or did this because others have asked for this, but not all. And it can happen that then you have not enough data in all details for your forecast, but you still want to make this fly. It's a very complex system. Yeah, this is another flight. You see all these pictures then are still used to discuss this, and this color scheme shows about the amount of this species. It's a potential vorticity in this case. It shows how a bit if you are in a polar region, for example, or in a normal atmospheric region. So we have a lot of documentation about this. It's we are on Bitbucket with the project. We have it as a ConnaForge application. And also, if you like more to read about the mechanism, how to use this in science, or you can go to the paper of Mark. And also, a lot of documentation is online as PDF. So there were already some measurements by this aircraft using the software. It started in 2014 with an aircraft mission at the MLCirrus. Then we were in Kiruna. Now we had Stratoclim. This was in Kalamata and India. Nordex was Iceland. Weiss is the next, is in Ireland. There are some more. And at all, there is, if you like to make science, it's maybe interesting to make it at a group where all these instruments are. Maybe you can build software for those instruments, software to use the data. And also, these people, they have always nice, interesting countries where they have to go with the aircraft. So that's maybe also an interesting aspect to get there and to learn maybe or improve their software. Okay. I'm not that sure how much time. Oh, I'm in time. Have you questions?
Do you have any idea how to make other research aircraft teams around the world embrace this software and how to make the community use it? Because from what I've seen here, it's mostly the German community and maybe the DLR, etc. What about the whole UFAR fleet, NCAR, etc.?
Yeah, also we are, one of the steps to go to this point was to have a demo data set included so that it's much easier to see how the server component has to be structured. And at the moment, there's another group from Bremen who adds their product there. And we have written to everyone using the aircraft mission systems we are also on, so that they can use it. And it's just a part of improvement of everything. Also, we are on this. But it's some, as there are already ECM WF data on it, and it's the same product on the OGC webmap service, that some have also other tools, and we'd like to be compatible always. Okay, one more question. We can export the flight tracks, exchange with the other peoples, and also we have just now for the next campaign, which has very complicated subset, we have in preparation beforehand a meeting and trying to find out what are the important interests of people are. So, and we do this with old data. And so it's just usually you can move, if you now someone is interested in this part and it's not so important for you, you can just say, okay, we make your decision for this. And on the other hand, if it's maybe against, you can say at the next time you will follow yours. So there's more than one flight usually in this campaign.